The study is part of a USGS study to understand the mechanisms of botulism, type E botulism on the Great Lakes. And so we're interested in foraging patterns and distribution of common loons and other water birds on the Great Lakes. In this case, we're radio marking common loons to get precise location information during migration. And they're also fitted with a geolocator tag, which provides us information on diving depths. We use a combination of calls. Between the calls and the lights, it holds the bird's attention enough that we're able to move in on it and scoop it up with a landing net. The transmitters that we're putting in will be operating for over a year. In addition to providing us information during the migration period, it'll also provide us location information during the wintering period. So we'll know if these birds migrate to the Gulf Coast or the Atlantic Coast, how long they spend there, what their fate is, and if they should happen to be a victim of the oil spill, we could have an opportunity to recover the birds by triangulating in on the signal.
We estimate we have about 12,000 loons in Minnesota. This is the largest number of loons in the lower 48 states. So we could have, you know, several thousand loons at least, juveniles heading south each winter. And those birds are at special risk because they stay in salt water, mostly in the Gulf of Mexico, to some extent on the Atlantic seaboard, for 2 years. They don't come back to Minnesota until they're 3 years old. So those birds are going to be continually exposed to whatever pollution exists, and this places them at high risk for mortality.
We're taking some basic measurements of the bird, also a sample of blood for later analysis for such things as mercury concentration. We're saving a sample of blood that we can use to look at potential genetic damage, or at least we have baseline information this year that we can compare to the birds next year when presumably they may be exposed to oil in the Gulf. It's great work. It's a lot of fun to work with loons, and especially when we feel like we can contribute to the management of the species, gather additional information to help resource managers develop conservation strategies both regionally and nationally. So that's very rewarding work.
You know, these birds are really vulnerable. You want to do something to help. In Minnesota, there's not a lot we can do about the oil spill. But the more we can learn about their ecology here, their migrations, it helps us anticipate what's going on and share the information we do have with the public.